Good evening. Welcome to Holy Name Cathedral as we celebrate the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We extend a special welcome to all parishioners and visitors who join our parish community to celebrate the Eucharist. The readings can be found at number 1181 in the worship hymnal in your pew. At this time, please be sure to turn off or silence all cell phones and mobile devices. Thank you. The celebrant of this Mass is Bishop Robert Lombardo, concelebrated by priests of the Archdiocese and assisted by Deacon Jose Cisneros. Please rise. Please join in singing our entrance hymn, Lord of All Hopefulness, which can be found at number 686 in the worship hymnal.
Lord of all hope, on us, Lord of all joy, whose trust and Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
With your spirit.
Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Holy Name Cathedral. We're very happy that all of you have been able to join us this afternoon as we pray at this Mass in thanksgiving to Almighty God for the blessing of being able to come together from many nations around the world. We know that we are united in Christ, regardless of our home of origin. We are all children of God. And we also know that among children there can be some difficulties caused by sin, whether it's thought, word, or deed. So let us now call to mind those times when sin has been an obstacle to our relationship with God or one another, and let us ask for pardon and peace so we can enter more fully into these sacred mysteries.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that, by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lectura del libro del profeta Isaías. Busquen al Señor mientras lo puedan encontrar. Invóquenlo mientras está cerca. Que el malvado abandone su camino y el criminal sus planes. Que regrese al Señor y Él tendrá piedad. A nuestro Dios, que está siempre dispuesto al perdón. Mis pensamientos no son los pensamientos de ustedes. Sus caminos no son mis caminos, dice el Señor. Porque así como aventajan los cielos a la tierra, así aventajan mis caminos a los de ustedes y mis pensamientos a sus pensamientos. Palabra de Dios.
Czytanie z listu świętego Pawła Apostoła do Filipian. Bracia, Chrystus będzie uwielbiony w moim ciele, czy to przez życie, czy przez śmierć. Dla mnie bowiem żyć to Chrystus, a umrzeć to zysk. Jeśli bowiem żyć w ciele, to dla mnie owocna praca. Co mam wybrać? Nie umiem powiedzieć. Z dwóch stron doznaję naleganie. Pragnę odejść i być z Chrystusem. Bo to o wiele lepsze. Pozostawać zaś w ciele to bardziej dla koniecznie. A ufnie w to wiem, że pozostanie i to pozostanie nadal dla was wszystkich, dla waszego postępu i radości wierzy, aby rosła wasza duma w Chrystusie przez mnie, przez moją ponowną obecność u was. Tylko sprawujcie się w sposób godny Ewangelii Chrystusowej, abym ja, czy gdy przebędę i ujrzę was, czy też będąc z daleka, mógł usłyszeć o was, zetwacze mocno w jednym duchu, jednym sercem walcząc wspólnie o wiarę w Ewangelii i w niczym nie dajecie się zastraszyć przeciwnikom. Właśnie dla nich jest zapowiedzią zagłady, a dla was zbawienia, i to przez Boga. Wam bowiem z łaski dane jest to dla Chrystusa. Nie tylko w Niego wierzyć, ale i dla Niego cierpieć. Skoro toczycie samą walkę, jaka u mnie widzieliście, a ja, jakiej u mnie teraz słyszycie. Oto Słowo Boże. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard, going out about 9 o'clock. The landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon, and around 3 o'clock, and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones were only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord.
Well, once again, good afternoon to everyone. Buenas tardes. Dzień dobry. Dobry wieczór, if that's better. Buonasera. Bon dia. That's about all I could do. I would try the Swahili, but I butcher that every time I try it. So you could teach me after Mass, because you wouldn't understand what I was saying anyway. So don't worry, you're not going to get the homily five times in five languages. So put your minds at ease. You'll get one homily and it'll be in English. How's that? Everybody in agreement? All right, very good. Oh, they're even applauding. This is great. I didn't even make a point and they're applauding. Look at this. Who would have thought? Who would have thought? But everybody likes a short homily, right? How many of you out there like a short homily? Oh, very good. This is my kind of crowd. Excellent. And you know what? It's going to be even shorter than I would had planned, because last night I was at the Notre Dame Ohio State game, and I said to myself, you must be Ohio State fans, because we got beat in the last 3 seconds of that game. It was a great game. It was a lot of fun to be there, but I said, I am not going to shout at all. There were enough people there to shout, because I said, I can't lose my voice, because I had a Mass this morning at Notre Dame, and then I have this one here. So if my voice doesn't make it to the end of Mass, we have a lot of people on the bench over there that could just step in. So here's the deal with today's homily. Our Lord said, go out to all the world and spread the good news, didn't he? Preach, teach all nations what I have taught you, and baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Right? Right. And look today, we have right here in the cathedral, as you look around, we have the words of Jesus come to life among us. Right? The word has gone out to the whole world, and we have a small example, a small witness to the power of the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the challenge continues. We have to still go out and proclaim the good news. And in today's gospel passage, we see an obstacle. When I was a young pup, I started out as a Franciscan many, many years ago, before most of you were born. And when I was in formation, one of the old friars, who was a riot, he was very, very, very funny. And he taught us something that I think is very important. He said, fellas, be careful of the green monster. The green monster. You're thinking, what is the green monster? Envy. Jealousy, And isn't that what we see in today's gospel passage? Right? Some people go out, they're told to go work in the vineyard for a full day's pay at 9 o'clock. Others at 12, 3, right? And what happens? Psst, 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 psst. You know what they got paid? You know what I got paid? That's blah, blah, blah. Jealousy. And what does God teach us? That he is lavish and generous with everybody. And so we should concentrate and stay focused on Jesus, right? Stay focused on the bounty, the beauty, the grandeur, the mercy of God, which knows no bounds. And not get caught up in the petty, picayune little things. And that can happen so readily, can't it? Who do you root for in soccer? Who? Messi, all right? And you're from Argentina, so we expect that. Do you think that the people in India are rooting for him? They're not. They're not. Right? They're not. What about the Mexicans? Are they rooting for Messi? Oh, Colombia. Oh, even better, right? So you see what I'm getting at. We could get all entrenched in all of this type of nonsense, and we can lose our focus on Jesus. So my message today is very simple. The message of Jesus goes out to all the world, and it's good news of our salvation. That's the key. That's the key, that God promised us eternal life. Isn't it? When we'll see our God as he is, and every tear will be wiped away. No more toothache. No more headache. No more COVID. Right? That's what we should stay focused on. So as we continue on with this Mass, let us pray in thanksgiving for the blessing to be able to see the fruits of Jesus' words here among us. Go out to all the world and preach the good news, and you see the results. And let us pray that God will continue to use us as instruments to continue to go out and spread that good news. All right? Yes? Are you ready? Are you ready, messy or not? Right? With or without, there you go. Because the important thing is who? All right, one person knew. All right, very good, very good. I'm gonna have you talk to the rest of them after Mass, all right? Because that was an easy one. That was a softball pitch, underhand. So you all got it, right? Good, amen. Now let us stand and profess our faith that comes to us from the apostles. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. With confidence, we now approach our Heavenly Father and make our needs known to Him.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos, oye mis ojos, dingin mocani. Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos, oye mis ojos, dingin mocani.
Ki hamara church शरणार्थियों, अप्रवासियों और प्रवासियों के हमारे देश में स्वागत, सुरक्षा, प्रचार और एककरण की प्रक्रिया के माध्यम से हर तरह से काम कर सके।
Vescovi della nostra Chiesa, affinché ciascuno sia incoraggiato delle nostre preghiere e del nostro sostegno per continuare guidando il popolo di Dio nella costruzione di una cultura che rispetti la dignità umana di tutti i migranti. Preghiamo il Signore.
Kama atuwa kumanya ntulitwa niliza omuntu yenna akonkona kunzigiza fe tufuna omukisa okusinkana mukama wa fe Yesu Kristu. We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escucha.
Cầu nguyện cho các thanh thiếu niên được đem đến đây khi còn thơ ấu. Xin cho họ có được những cơ hội mà họ xứng đáng đón nhận.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escucha.
Para sa lahat ng mga pamilya na pinuwersang takasan ang kanilang mga tahanan at mga bansa dahil sa digmaan, karahasan, kalupitan o kagutuman. Manalangin tayo sa mga pamilya na isinakay sa mga bus at dinala rito sa Illinois at iba pang sanctuary states or cities na dala lamang ay kakaunting gamit o bag. Naway sila ay mabigyang respeto, dignidad, at pagmamahal para sa kanilang bagong buhay dito. Manampalataya tayo sa Panginoon.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escucha.
Mungu, Baba, tunaomba ufungue mioyo na mikono yetu ili tuweze kuwapokea wahamiaji na vipaji vyao kama ndugu zetu katika Kristo, we pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos. Oye mis ruegos, dignimo cani.
Kita berdoa agar kita dapat mendengar dan menjawab ini aku kepada nilai-nilai Injil. Untuk saling menerima satu sama lain, terutama saudara dan saudari kita, imigran. We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos. Oye mis ruegos, dignimo cani.
We pray this day for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially here in our archdiocese and to the many religious communities represented here. We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos.
Heavenly Father, we ask you now in your goodness to hear and to answer these spoken prayers and the unspoken prayers that remain in the quiet of our hearts, all of which we place before you through the intercession of Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Thank you.
Let us now pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood,
the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. So we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us give each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. Señor, yo no soy digno de que estés en casa, pero una palabra tuya basta.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Normally at Mass, there's a collection and announcements. Now, you had the collection, so we got that over with, so it is a valid Mass. And in lieu of announcements, we're going to have two witness talks. So I'd ask everybody to please be seated for a few minutes.
My name is Elena Segura. I am with the Immigration Ministry and the National Pastoral Migratoria in the Archdiocese of Chicago. Today is the last day of the National Migration Week that intends to echo Pope Francis' call to deepen our understanding of the complex issues driving forced migration and renew our commitment to respond. Many churches in this archdiocese and other dioceses in the country have engaged in prayer, reflection, and action on behalf of immigrants. You will hear two testimonies on how parishes in the archdiocese work together with Catholic charities and other collaborators welcoming recently arrived migrants. Thank you for your presence today.
Good evening. My name is Mauro Pineda with Immigration Ministry of the Archdiocese of Chicago, summarizing, with the family's permission, their experience. This family left the extreme violence and poverty in Haiti. They traveled to Brazil, then navigated South America. After Colombia and before Panama, there is a 60-mile stretch of jungle known as the Darien Gap. No roads, which they tread on foot. Now, to put that in perspective, a marathon is 26.2 miles, but it is run by those who prepare, are continuously hydrated, and wear proper attire. These are 60 miles of inhospitable jungle which this family and many from Venezuela, among other parts of the world, traverse perilously. Over half of them die there. Migrants come to us with physical, emotional, psychological, and spiritual trauma. That is why we, as faithful Catholics, welcome them.
Good afternoon. My name is Celine Wasnica, and I'm here in representation of the Catholic community of Oak Park. I have been asked to talk about our efforts to meet the needs of the migrants in our area. There are two important things to note from the beginning. We are a team that is part of a larger network, and we are interfaith. The Catholic community of Oak Park became involved in migrant ministry in early May when the migrants arrived to the District 15 police station in Austin, just two blocks from the Oak Park border. Members of the Catholic community joined the police station response team and immediately shared the need for food bedding, clothes, toiletry items, and other immediate needs. As the Catholic community, we dove right in, accompanying the migrants, collecting needed items, and bringing breakfast and lunches to the station on a regular basis every week. We also nag-vocated, which is a really good word, to get the closed rectory of St. Catherine St. Lucie opened twice a week for the migrants to take showers. On shower day, the migrants are not only able to bathe, but also enjoy a full breakfast and can select from donated clothing. After showering, a group of women head down to the rectory kitchen to cook typical Venezuelan food, arepas, cachapas, and other delights. It is so life-giving. Another note about shower day is that the volunteers come from all different faith centers in the area. A number of these congregations are interested in partnering with us and Catholic Charities to resettle and accompany asylum-seeking families. We are currently resettling our third family in Oak Park in collaboration with Catholic Charities and celebrate the network that we are developing to facilitate this process. We also nag-vocate to our elected officials to make Oak Park a more welcoming community for migrants. And we are making progress in that effort. Let's broaden our Catholic outreach to migrants. Let's get every parish to respond in any way that they can to serve them. As Mauro described, they undertook an awful journey. We ought to wash their feet now and on Holy Thursday. Thank you.
Just a brief word to help to conclude our Mass and our celebration this afternoon. Having spent time as a young pup in the missions, I'm very well aware of some of the dire circumstances that people come from. And I didn't want to mention this in the homily because I thought it would be important to listen to the experience of some people who are actually going through it at this period in time. We are all united in Christ, meaning we are all brothers and sisters. So think to yourself of your own siblings, and if they were in need, how would you respond? And I think that gives us a blueprint for how to go forward. And I want to say this as well, because it's not only our parishes that are reaching out. I direct and run the mission of Our Lady of the Angels, and on any given week, we're helping out 700 to 1,000 migrant families with food, clothing, and goods to get set up in an apartment. Many of them are living with relatives, and they need things like kitchenware. We don't think of that. So if they're going to get reestablished, there are many, many things that they need. So imagine yourself graduating college and trying to set up an apartment in a foreign city where you have a new job. And I think I would speak for most of us that we have some items in our kitchens, our garages, attics, and basements that we really don't use and we really don't need, but there is a tremendous need on the part of our brothers and sisters. So also, Jesus started a church, not just a parish. So look beyond the parish, because there are religious communities that are doing things. There are a lot of ways that you can get involved. And we have to broaden our horizon to understand what church means. And church is much broader than parish. Parish is part of church, but church is not exclusively parish. So I just want to say that as well. There are many ways you can get involved. So the Lord be with you. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen.
Must ascend it, go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in our recessional hymn, Called to Labor in God's Vineyard, found in your worship aid.